Hello, my name is Chris. I'm going to share today this permanent magnetic motor design of mine. Of course, it's a failure. I have several others that are failures as well. This is the first one, though. Actually, I finished this. This one's been done for almost 9 months, I'd say. This is my first attempt to go into the, what I call the third dimension, so to speak. You got an X, Y, and take it into the Z plane as well. Like I said, really nothing new here. This one here, actually I'm using a 1-inch throat crankshaft. There's an interstator in there with 50 magnets on it. I'm using round, 1/4-inch diameter magnets. With another 50 magnets dropping around the OD. Of the inner rotor. I mean, I don't really call this a stator. I guess you could call it a stator, but it's not really a stator. Kind of like a stator, but anyway, it does not work. Basically, like I said, this is a crankshaft. Using a cam up here and a bunch of rocker arms here, and there's magnets underneath there. I'll take apart here in a minute. Of course, it goes round and round. I can pretty much make it run neutral. Lock it up. Anyway, I can take apart here, and I'm really curious how many other people have experimented in the third dimension. Some other nicer stuff, get out of the XY plane. I got previous versions, they're mostly all XY plane stuff. Oh, slide this over, and I'll take it apart real quick. Pretty simple thing. Basically, to be honest with you, this thing's really a look like a 1915 radio engine design. You know, it really. Lot too. Pretty simple stuff. I didn't get too carried away on my, say, valve spring geometry there. I mean, it's as simple as possible. But, jerk stator off over here real quick. Come on, sweetie. Anybody should get off that. Gotta love that. Now you can see the inner rotor rotating about the 1-inch throw. See the magnets that I'm just using. Flathead stainless steel screws that lock the magnets in. No big deal here. Pretty simple stuff. Cam. I have numerous designs of these cams. Some directional, some maybe not so directional. Haven't made any of them work yet. And the stator part, so to speak. But I don't know if you really call that a stator. Kind of funky, you know what I'm saying? They're just a bunch of magnets going around in a circle. Big deal. Try to drop them to engage. Of course, everybody knows, playing around with this stuff much, using round magnets, it makes an issue when you roll through the 45, one magnet, you know, likes to hit the other magnet, of course, it likes to go back the other way. And we got that E equals MC squared dude, he likes to come into play too. As soon as the cam drops, you know, that makes a opposite equal reaction, blah, blah, blah. You know the game there. Anyway, like I said, I did this one about 9 months ago. Thinking about some other designs. A lot of them get so much more mechanically involved that I get really concerned about all the mechanical drag. I'd like to take my cam assembly that I have now, my drop cam assembly, and have it run around the magnets in more of a sine wave form. Of course, making that work is, I'd have to change pivot points and basically redesign a lot of it. I've thought about several different ways to do it, haven't done it yet. Everything I think about turns into a mechanical nightmare. I'm hoping there's some people out there that post up some stuff. Says, oh yeah, we tried all this stuff back in, I don't know, 1930s, 40s, 50s, 60s, and have some really neat stuff that was all failures. You know, I even thought about stuff that's different things like, I don't know, pinwheels, you know, having multiple pinwheels engaging these into a pinwheel pattern back, and unless the right term, that's what I'll use, a pinwheel, even another one that could be more like a sun gear pattern, which everybody knows, you know, I'm talking about sun gear, you know what I mean, would have typical gear thing. Of course, be a whole bunch of magnets in there that, I don't know, it can just turn into be another whole mechanical nightmare, but I'm curious if anybody's actually played with some of this stuff. Put it out there, be curious, it might save me a lot of time and energy to build more junk that don't work. Like I said, this one don't work. It's probably just a lot of people come in, some people seen it, and man, pretty much, never mind. They probably are, you know, just throwing money down a rabbit hole. But it keeps my little brain happy or something, maybe something to think about. Done a lot of thinking about a bunch of other crazier stuff that, you know, if you get more into the world of Troids. One of them is kind of like a multi-layered Troid with a 3D Ferris wheel floating around inside of the dumb thing. And I don't know, I could probably go on for hours and hours and hours. Really don't want to bore anybody, but I thought I'd put this one out there. See if I get some people to, and maybe there's some books out there that I have not been able to get my hands on that shows some real cool representations of some stuff that people have tried over the past years. A little bottom banana place here, in case somebody asks. That's from a previous version. There was two of these, this lower plate and top plate. And everything's floating around the middle of my attempt to make what I call a null point. So it didn't work. But I'm currently working on, like I said, this is a crank version. Yeah, I have a non-crank version. And this one here is I got my rotor lock. Call it the non-rotary rotor. I got another one I call the rotary crank. If I can, you know, I pull it up, take off my engagement arm, and the rotor just also spins free, but that, I want to go into magnetic flux points on the in and out, the backside, the inside, blah, 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 blah. You know, just turned into a nightmare and timing issues, but anyway, I wanted to share this. It'd be interesting. Hopefully somebody will maybe call me back, talk about it. I'm hoping somebody said, oh yeah, we built one just like this in 1952 or 42 or something. Anyway, that's about it for this little segment. I hope somebody will call me back. And we'll talk to you later. Thank you.